the second half of the coming Sportz Rec League show. Please welcome your red team. They are John Gersberg, John McCormick, and their captain, Bill Peterson. Now give it up for your blue team. They are or something like that. And their captain, Dana Sharon. And once again, here's your referee in mind, Michael Brookmiller. Sabibi. Sabibi.
Hey, hey.
Something like, anyway.
Sabibi.
Whatever.
Okay, good score sends. We have two brand new teams. For this game. In the game of Justin Timbers, which what's going to happen is I'm going to come out to you guys and I will get a suggestion for a scene and then I will get a celebrity. At any point in time during a two-person scene, once the celebrity's name is mentioned, I will blow the whistle like this and then we'll all do this. Oh! Every line after that must have some type of reference to that celebrity. Right? Every single line has to have some type of reference to that celebrity. If it doesn't, then I will rotate them. It's again a rotation game, so Richie will keep track of the rotations.
Yep, I'll close my OK Cupid profile.
Thank you, Richie, thank you. Good. So this is a very hard game. Please, one player from each side on the field. Excellent. Mark, John, I need a suggestion for the scene of an object. Let's get that first.
Four.
What's that?
Oh, never mind. I understand.
Handkerchief. Thank you, Himanshu. I know him too. So handkerchief is your suggestion, and then I need a celebrity, please.
Cher.
Good. So Cher is your celebrity. Handkerchief is your suggestion. Players, are you ready?
Yes.
Super duper. Go.
Really? Really? In the sick ward. Look. I'm supposed to get the bad germs out. We're in a hospital, right? Yeah. Come on to everyone else, man. What? I don't think you know how science works or medicine. I am a doctor. That's why I'm getting my arm stale right now. I have to go in surgery right now.
Yeah,
I'm supposed to get the best of both. Look, I was supposed to bring you here like I Cher was brought onto the 1987 stage somewhere to sing a song. Look, I know you're partner is a senator or some kind of government official, but it's like take your kid to work day to day. Look, Sonny, I don't have time for you, okay? I'm a doctor. I have to take a goat's heart and put it in a human right now. But don't you care about me? It's almost like you've left me for somebody else.
Talking to a chair.
drink and swallow.
I sprained my leg earlier, so I have to walk carefully at these cocktail parties.
That's okay, let's go to my Gran Torino. I promise it'll be beautiful.
Are we going to your ranch?
Yes. As well, all the other men who only frown on
me. That's great.
Excellent. Can I get another suggestion for a scene, please? In other words. I need to die now.
Corn.
What's that?
Corn.
Corn, sure.
Corn.
And a new celebrity.
John Wayne.
Oh, we'll just toss on the grill here. Knee high about the 4th of July, you know what they say. But those little puppies roast up like that, they'll be good.
You're so knowledgeable about the grill, I didn't think anyone else would know how to use it, so I just left it there, waiting for you to come. Best friends!
I learned from the best. Learned from my Billy Idol.
Scott's too, so, would you like a drink, maybe lemonade?
We can drink that all the way to the rebel hour. Come on, Rebel.
I have something to show you. I bought this black jacket with a lot of chains and spikes on it. Do you think it makes me look cool and like someone you would want to hang out with all the time?
Buddy, you are making a comeback right now. Amazing.
Nice. And what's a comeback without comeback hair? Time to dye it, bleach, white.
Absolutely. They will never call you a dinosaur again.
Yes.
Kim Kardashian. Great, Kim Kardashian is your celebrity.
Oh.
Sure. And you're still porn though, still porn. So Kim Kardashian, new porn.
Oh my God, Johnson. That corn stalk is about 10 or 12 feet high. That's amazing.
Alright, we're gonna be rich. I'll get to the market.
You know, we're gonna be richer than Kim Kardashian. You bet my butt they are.
So do you have implants to, you know, eat it? Or some kind of implants?
Look, I just broke it like I broke some guy's career. Kansas isn't like Hollywood at all. Except sometimes some people get selfish and full of themselves.
This porn's real, it ain't fake or superficial. Here, have some.
Yes. That's amazingly organic corn, not fake or superficial at all. Why, if I had my own show, I would put you on it and you could do whatever you wanted to.
A job.
Veterinarian,
right, and somebody.
Schwarzenegger.
Arnold Schwarzenegger and veterinarian. They go hand in hand.
Did you just fix those wrinkles?
Oh God. Yes, I will look at your hamster. It's okay, Steve. I know that you hear him. You know, what was the name of your last hamster? Arnold.
Like little Schwarzenegger.
Oh, that's cute. You know, he looks
is twitching.
As long as he's not all steel on the inside.
A heart.
The game of Justin Timberswitch played by both teams. It shook out like this. The red team had two eliminations. The blue team had three, giving 5 points to the red team.
Very good. Captain Phil, I come to you to ask you, hey, what game do you want to play, buddy?
We want to play Scooby-Doo.
Scooby-Doo! Awesome. For the game of Scooby-Doo, I need a suggestion of some type of festival that you might go to. What's that?
Oktoberfest.
Good. Timely, because it's October. Good, so Oktoberfest is a suggestion. In the game of Scooby-Doo, the red team will come out and they will start making a scene. However, people in the scene may not be who they seem, such as in an episode of Scooby-Doo. So we're going to see some reveals, we're going to see some Oktoberfest, we're going to see some fun. Players are going to be ready.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Please begin with
Scooby-Doo.
Bill's is the best Oktoberfest ever.
Klaus, I'm so glad you finally came.
Yeah.
I must have been across the door.
Did you get it?
Oh.
This is the house.
Ooh.
You're more charming than other bits.
Yeah.
Oh. What? What do you think we can get some strudel?
Down to your own.
We're right here at the strudel cellar.
Ooh. Oh,
we have chicken strudel, beef strudel, person strudel.
Stay quiet that long. Who are you?
I'm not Flinch.
suggestion of spoon. At any point in time that they say something that I don't like, I'll do this. New choice, and I have to say something else. And then if I still don't like it, I can say new choice, and I have to say something else. Basically, they have to keep saying new stuff until I'm pleased on an aesthetic level.
Players, are you ready?
Yes!
Super to do, Perko!
New choice.
Candace, see, that's what I'm saying. Spooning doesn't work that way. I just don't...
I thought we just laid all the spoons in the house on the bed. And it was romantic. I tried to be romantic. I'm sorry. And now I don't like your cereal. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, baby.
I love you.
New choice.
I think pizza's wonderful.
New choice.
Swedish people are bad.
They are. Yeah, I mean, you can't eat that many meatballs.
I know. And romance is important. But what's the most important meal of the day?
Breakfast.
And if we don't have spoons, what meal can we have?
Breakfast. I mean, we could make eggs.
New choice.
We could go to the neighbors.
New choice.
We could clean up.
New choice.
We could go hungry.
Oh, Mom and Dad, I'm so hungry.
Oh,
New choice. Oh, God, I think I have dysentery. Enjoy.
My appendix. It is inflamed.
Spider, come on.
Your choice.
Ratatouille was an awful movie. And
your choice.
Sweet beans of yesteryear. I feel like you're faking it again just for attention.
It is the third time this week you said you had inflamed.
Those bullies at school. Oh. Yeah, just I can't stand them.
Oh, honey.
Could you just work me over?
Yeah.
Right. They're gonna just take my lunch money.
You're right.
Oh, I'm gonna have to do their homework.
You're right.
Well, I'm gonna have to beat them up myself this time.
You're right.
I'm the principal, and they're just
taking Honey, you want your dad to go with you again?
I don't think somebody wants to be homeschooled.
I'm 36, though.
I am tired of homeschooling him.
Guys.
I can do it. I can do it again. Yeah. Romance yes. Homeschool, that's hard.
I love you. Yesteryear. Shut the door, Marge. I know that's not your name, but I just feel like... Samson and Delilah is playing on the radio, and I just feel like we should experience some kind of... Spooning.
Do you want me to cut your hair? Do you want me to put forks in the bed? Do you want to do the dishes first or later?
Choice.
Do you want to turn that radio off?
New choice.
Do you really want everything?
New choice.
Do you think?
New choice.
I'm divorcing you.
The game of New Choice played by the blue team.
the entire 90 second scene and compress it down to 45 seconds. And then, at the end of 45 seconds, well, the game was called countdown, so I'm going to take that time and cut it in half. Then I'll do the whole 90-second scene in 22 seconds. And then after 22 seconds, well, the game is called countdown. So I'm going to take that 22 seconds, cut it in half to 11 seconds, and then they're going to have the 11 seconds to do the entire 90-second scene. And after that, we'll see what happens. Players, are you ready?
Yeah!
Good. Here's the game of countdown. Please begin the whistle.
Countdown.
Wow, honey. This is a pretty empty shaft. I don't need one.
I'm pretty sure this is the only horse I have when I was a little girl.
Oh, wow. I'll tell you one thing, sir. Let's hear it. His eyes light up like that. You're going to be buying everything in this silver.
Oh, and
wallet.
Wait a minute.
Oh,
I bet. That was my chair in my room when I was a little girl.
That's great. You know, the memory's coming back.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, we should do it. We should buy something and go. I think, you know. We got music boxes over here.
Wait a minute.
We gotta bring the kids out from school.
That was my music box when I was a little girl. And this is my music box from my memories.
You know, honey, I think your grandma's coming. You know, we gotta pick her up from the airport. Why don't we go?
I bet your grandma would love to see all the antiques in the house. She would. She loves antiques.
Oh, yeah. You can pick her up from school. Don't forget about the kids.
Oh,
the kids like antiques, I'm sure, too.
Wait, this is our kid right here.
Hang on.
Jimmy? Oh!
Jimmy, how are you getting here?
Look at how vintage Jimmy is. He started us, too, when he went to school. Now he's eight. Oh. Wait a minute.
I'm not sticking out this in. We should buy two.
There we go.
Shoes is the horse I had when I was a little girl.
I see that twinkle in her eye. You're gonna buy the whole store.
My wallet.
Wait a minute, that's
the memories. Let them flow.
Let them flow. Just get one thing and go.
I'm pretty sure I bought this one.
Do you see the music box still here?
Music box.
Oh, here I get all these kids up from school.
Wait, I had this music box when I was a little girl.
I'm gonna take all your money.
You know, your grandma's at the airport. We need to pick her up.
She loves antiques.
All grab the suit.
Oh, right, the kids.
6 seconds.
Wait a minute, that's our kid there, Jimmy.
He's older. He's so vintage.
Yeah. Get
out of the school.
I will give you you one bonus point for sweet beans of yesteryear. I need to get three different locations or times. So can I get like an everyday location you might go to?
Grocery store.
Grocery store, thank you. How about some type of big historical event?
Renaissance.
Renaissance, excellent. So grocery store, the Renaissance. And then how about something, a situation, a place we'd love to go to but you couldn't afford it or 2 acres?
Office in this.
Well, actually, it'll be in the same place. So you have, I'm going to take Mount Vesuvius. So Mount Vesuvius, you have the grocery store and you have the Renaissance. We will start you off in the grocery store, okay? So in this game of Parallel Universe, this team is going to start off in the grocery store. However, at any point in time during their scene, I will do this. And I will say another place or another location. They have to jump to that location, but they have to maintain their body position and justify why they're in that body position and location. Every time we go to the location again, the characters will remain the same,
and it's gonna be fun.
Players, are you ready?
Yes!
Super duper perky Virgo in that doing stuff.
Parallel Universe.
Cindy, these tomatoes, they're overripe. These strawberries already have a whole lot.
This grocery store is disgusting.
You guys should really try the beans.
Oh.
Because they're frozen.
Do you work here?
Sometimes.
Well, I would like to speak to a manager because all of this produce is no good.
Listen, my wife and I just moved in at your house. We're just a little bit of fish. You put it in Mount Vesuvius.
I feel like the clouds are really ashy.
Why am I touching the volcano? The red stuff, stay away from the red long stuff, okay? I don't know much about what's going on, but that is a dangerous omen.
Ooh, I just feel like the gods have, like, left us.
It's, like, really ashy.
I've invented the shovel!
Things are changing for the best.
Can you guys tell me my dress is very heavy? The corset is like stuck and someone just like...
Leonardo!
Can you just...
What's something up for him? Grocery store.
Oh god, the smells of this produce are...
It's amazing, isn't it?
No!
Interesting. Applaud now for coming out.
screwed that up. Hang on, I'll fix it. There we go.
Ah, yes. And audience, thank you for understanding my subtle clue. So, the captain, please approach the playing field. It is time for the last chance for points game. What are we going to play?
When I grow up.
When I grow up, do you accept?
Do I have a choice?
Nope. Let's do it. Super. Please let me in the when I grow up formation. Which is a line. In this game of When I Grew Up, what's going to happen is the players are going to be transported back to their childhood. And they are going to, I'm going to get from you either different occupations or different somethings. And they'll say, when I grow up, I want to be a, or when I grow up, I'd like to have a, whatever. And then they will deliver some type of punny line with their when I grow up. If they make you laugh, moan, or groan, basically any sound from the neck up, I'll do this. And if it's awkwardly silent, like now, I'll say no, and they'll get no points. It is currently 16 to 20, so the blue team has a little catching up to do. Let's see how this works. Can I get from you? Let's get a profession first off. Let's start there.
Astronaut.
Great, astronaut. Astronaut is your suggestion for suggestion. Players, are you ready?
Yeah.
Super, go.
When I grow up, I want to be the astronaut because the blue's made cheese, and I like cheese.
When I grow up, I don't want to be an astronaut because I don't want to suffocate.
Gosh,
when I grow up, I want to be an astronaut because I don't like drinking water, so everything's dehydrated.
Yes.
When I grow up, I want to be an astronaut because my grandma says the sky's the limit.
Oh. Yeah.
When I grow up, I want to be an astronaut because I'm such a blast.
When I grow up, I want to be an astronaut so I can pee in my suit.
When I grow up, I want to be an astronaut so my mom will finally give me some space.
Oh.
When I grow up, I want to fall in love with being an astronaut
because
I feel
weightless.
When I grow up, I want to
stay right there. Can I have an object that you may possess?
Typewriter.
Typewriter! When I grow up, I want to have a typewriter. Or I don't want to have a typewriter. Let's figure it out.
When I grow up, I want to have a typewriter so I can figure out what makes people tick. Tick, 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 tick.
When I grow up, I want to have a typewriter so I can hit the right key.
When I grow up, I want to be a typewriter so I can hit all the keys.
No.
I don't want a typewriter because I can't write.
No.
When I grow up, I don't want to be a typewriter because I don't want to be down the times.
When I grow up, I want to be a typewriter so I can return to wherever I want.
Giraffe, good. Giraffe is your suggestion. I either want or don't want a giraffe. Go!
When I grow up, I don't want to be a giraffe because I don't want to stick my neck out for people.
Oh. When I grow up, I want a giraffe because I'm a Toys R Us kid. When I grow up, I want to be a giraffe so I can look down on all of you.
When I grow up, I want to be a giraffe because I like to eat leaves in tall trees.
Good. There. Another profession.
Optometrist.
Hi, doctor.
Okay. When I grow up, I want to be an optometrist so I can see the world.
Nick. When I grow up, I want to be an optometrist because I want everything to be focused.
Yeah. When I grow up, I want to be an optometrist so I can speculate.
So I can see all of you.
No.
When I grow up, I want to be an optometrist so I have specs of you.
Yeah, yes, you're right there, yeah. Can I get another, let's get another job.
Construction.
Accountant, let's get accountant. They're funny, the construction workers. Accountant!
When I grow up, I want to be an accountant because you can count on me.
Oh. No.
When I grow up, I want to be an accountant because I want life to add up.
When I grow up, I want to be an accountant because I don't want to enjoy most of my days.
The game of When I Grow Up, played by both teams.
We are getting the final scores in a minute where Richie is tabulating them, but first I'd like to have a big round of applause for Richie McCoy. Sportz Rec League show here Saturday or Sunday, the 18th of October. But did you know we have county sports shows Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at 8 o'clock? What? It's true, we do! All those shows are family friendly, which means you can bring your kids, you can bring your parents, and as I said, you won't have to explain anything on the way. Oh, we also have shows on Friday night, and for the month of October, it's the Headless Horseman Uns, an unscripted ghost story. That one is not necessarily for the kids. You may have to explain things on the way home. There's no brown bag found that, but it's 10:30 on Friday. Also on Saturday, we have 10:30, the NC-17 show, which again, as the name implies, is not for parents or kids. Just for the middle people. I don't know. That's Saturday, 10:30. It's a whole lot of fun in short form improv like you see here, but again, no brown bag foul, so things are said that will make people blush. All that and more at our website, which is countysportstc.com. Now, get out of the way, please!
Absolutely. Going into that game, it was 20-16 in favor of the red team. The red team scored 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 points for a total score of 30. The blue team also played that game. They scored 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and that's it! The game goes to the red team! Ladies and gentlemen, give one final round of applause for your players as they exit the arena! They have been John Gersberg, Mark Janik, John McCormick, Andy Sestivi, your winning captain Phil Peterson, your losing captain Dana Sheridan.